get my shoes on. There we go. Okay. Dude. All right. We'll get started in a second. Let's double check if we got everything moving all right. Audio levels seem okay at this point. We will see. We might have to adjust. First, we gotta. This stuff works, but man, it tastes horrible. Terrible. Not be alive. Okay, so we have Power Intervals number 4 is our last time trial workout. And I really, really want to get it over with. We have the entire week to work on it, but I would much prefer just getting it done. But it's going to be not long, it's 57 minutes, and it will not feel good. So, I'm thinking what we do is we start out with a 10 minute warm up on a small Robo Pacer group. Let's see, is this the one that we always do? I think this is the one that we've repeated every time. Yeah. We'll hang with everybody here. Okay, so the power intervals are a little bit interesting because we got like the AC but in reverse and then just a bunch of 2 minute holds in zone 5. So I think we'll be able to pull it off. We'll see how we feel here. All our pre-workout concoction will have jumped into gear by then. Okay, that is a Christmas sweater. I don't know where you get it, but I want it so bad. Let's see if we can catch up to him and check it out. Oh, there's like 2 people who have them. 3! Where did we get that from? 1, 2, 3, 4? The Christmas stuff. That's awesome. Oh. That's one sound downside of the big groups is you get a lot of draft, but you miss all the ride-ons. I feel bad. And another Christmas sweater. Kit, whatever. All right. So, power intervals for today are actually rated lower than the ones we did last week or 2 weeks ago. It might have been 2 weeks ago. But it's only by like 2 points. So, that's we're probably not going to notice in the end, is the thing. But it is supposed to be easier. All zone 5 stuff. So, that'll be interesting. Again, 57 minutes. So we'll just hold on. Last time during the 2 minute intervals, I had to drop down to a think it was like 75, so lower cadence than usual. But that worked. So we'll keep that in our back pocket just in case things get gnarly. We can just default to low cadence and hold on. We'll shoot for the regular 90-95, somewhere in there. On the 2 minute, probably 85-90. That is a nice Scott. I like that frame. I can't remember if that's, which one that is. I've always liked the Scott Addict. That is a cool frame. It's super light. My resume and letting me know, hey, this is actually working. I get to work from home 3 days a week for the job that I deserve, but didn't think it out there. We're not sticking with this group very well today. That's weird. Okay, it looks like we peaked into zone 4 for a second. We'll try to keep that a little bit lower for the warm-up. Try to keep around 180. I'll keep us in the 2.2 watts per kilogram. Just right on what we want for warm-ups. Except it looks like the multiplier has gotten a lot quicker with this last update. Because we're almost all the way out of times one, we're 3/4 of the way there within under 5 minutes. And last time, when was it? We had that RoboPacer 2 weeks ago. We were hanging with them for like 10-15, and we're just barely getting out of like 1.2 multiplier. So I like that. I like the new, we're already seeing good things from the new update. Cadence for a second. Get everything moving. Heart rate's a lot higher than we want it to be, but that's how our warm-ups usually are. So, fingers crossed. We'll see. Either way. Oh, they did adjust the multiplier. I forgot about that. Yeah, 2.5. I'm excited about that. I was sad that it was capping out at 2. At least 2.5 gives us some more distance to cover. If we can stick with the pacer. How do we keep falling off the back and now we're leaving out the front? We can just not find a good spot. All right, so we are 6 minutes. Let's do another 7 to 10, then we'll hop in. Yeah, I'm definitely the 2.0 seemed to help up really quick. And then, like you said, you kind of lose motivation. There's like not as much to go after. And you just sit at 2. And I didn't really, you know, I wasn't quite as happy with how fast the numbers were going up. I like the flashy lights and numbers and stuff in 2.5. That's a good spot to see all the points going quick. Alright, let's see. We're kind of bouncing between 2 and 3. Which, that's fine. As long as we stay out of 4. We will get all warmed up. Usually when we start getting into 4, start burning up some, a little more energy than we want. Hopefully we get a break in the heart rate here. It's staying a lot higher than we want it to be. So you know what? Let's pop up 2 gears. I'll slow down to the 80s. See if that helps. The goal is 140 by the time we start the workout. May or may not be possible. Either way, we'll see what happens. It'll be okay. Hopefully. Hopefully. That's the key word. Hopefully. It's also way too hot. It was really cold this morning, so burned like 2 or 3 layers. Alright, let's see. Maria's kind of dropped off the back. Oh, our multiplier reset. Darn it. Oh, we need to turn down the gain on the mic. It's a little bit loud. All right, that should be better. All right, you know what? This group seems to be sticking right where we want it to be, or what we're hoping for, so let's hang with them for a while. We can forego the multiplier for right now, and we'll just hang out, you know? Of that reset, like I can't find the spot where the reset occurs. I've had a reset on me at like what, 20 meters. I've had it hold on to like up to 42. I'm not sure if I just had like a lag spike and it got confused and dropped it on me or what, but it's so frustrating. It is definitely a little demoralizing when you see the multiplier go back down to 1.0. Yeah, it seems very, I don't know, it jumps around where it decides that your multiplier's lost. I wish it was more consistent or easier to anticipate. I don't know if like the hills or the anything affect that drop-off zone, if they want you to keep closer on like uphills or downhills or how, but so frustrating. I just want points. I just want the points. But I guess it definitely forces you to pack up really close right next to the pacer. Let's see, we're going Mech Island. We'll do a couple more minutes around this zone 2. I don't know why my Siri just went off. Something I had said translated to Siri. Yeah, now it didn't work. That didn't work. For some reason, previously it did. That was really strange. Alright, let's see. Alright, we're in 0 pack of loss. We took that one hop out of the network. It looks like it took care of it. I don't know what was going on Saturday. It looks like the issue was from access switch to core switch. There was a hop in the middle, which is really bad design, but bypassing that seems to fix it. We're at 0%. Okay with that. I wish it was easier to catch back up that XP. I always feel like I lose out on a ton of it. It would be cool. nice. It would make things more streamlined. I wonder if they do tests on production or only on the non-production builds. It seems like there's really no trial period. It's just, it's out and then it's out. And then you run into some interesting overlooked pieces. But I guess that's how, you know, most software goes. Let's see, 13 minutes. We'll start slowing down here for a second. And then we'll hop in to the big stuff. Okay, so our trainer is taking a break in the day. There, it's back. Okay, we have like a budget of two of those per day usually, so that's one down, one to go. Get an EMP'd or whatever, let's see. I tried adjusting the USB ports it was connected to for the Amp Plus adapter and no dice. It is definitely just the computer being dumb. It's almost fixed. We're almost there, we're getting there. It is taking its time, or I guess we are taking our time to get it fixed. All right, we're at 14. Okay, we're at 140. You know what? Let's not push it and call our luck there. All right, so we have like a 15-minute warm-up for the workout itself. So, okay, this is gonna be fun-ish, kinda. Let's see, can we get? You should get a decent amount of a distance, and not that big of a hill, but. One's a good mix between distance and just a little tiny bit of height. We could probably finish that segment in time. The other one's 38 and 900. I don't think we'd be able to make it within that workout. All right, lots of zone five. Here we go. Last one. Again, we are two TSS points lower than the previous one, so we'll just hold on to that. We'll use that as a incentive to finish, that today is easier-ish. We will see though. I don't know how, what exactly determines if we shifted gears. That was not good. I don't know what, determines the TSS or how that works, or if it's more impacted by distance, or if it's more impacted by like cadence or wattage or how it is. Whatever it is, we will see. We can use today as a check to see how it compares. Okay. Worried we're getting too much water in. We don't want to have that uncomfortable halfway through the race. We got to take a break moments. Especially, we're not going to be able to hop back on very comfortably. Oh, I gotcha. That makes sense. Thank you. I was wondering about that. I get it. Ooh, so we're just under FTP. I like that. I like that. We can pull that. Or at least pretend to. Let's see. So we have... Okay, so they're giving us a slightly different warm-up today. So back and forth zone 2. Back and forth zone 3. And we get 1 minute. And then we get the ramp downs instead of ramp ups. And then the secondary sprint. All right. Last one. You just gotta remember, last one. No more after this. Well, the time trial workouts. That's a cool bike. What is that? That frame right to our, what is that? 9 o'clock? Or was? That looks familiar. I can't remember what it is, but I like that frame. That blue one. I like the fade colors. Where it goes from two extremes. That just looks good. It looks really good. I think Madone has one of their Project One colors is like orange to is it just dark red? I think it's dark red and it looks really good. I like it a lot. Oh! Somebody just drift in there. That was impressive. They've got counter steering down to a T. Alright. We're a little jumpy, so the heart rate is definitely still staying high. Let's try that. Back down a little bit. Make sure we're in a good position. Keep scooting back on the seat. Okay. Just keep it under 160. I don't know why. It's just jumping clear up there today. That happens. I think it was 2, 3, 4? Last week, at some point, my heart is stuck at 160. We cannot get it down. Let's check. Yeah, the watch has just become completely unreliable. We'll have to just stick with the chest heart rate. I think they're trying to read off of each other and causing problems. Now on back. All right, 23 seconds. Then we start the back and forth. We only got two of each, so that's not bad. That'll be good. Finish off our warm up with some accelerations, just a little bit. That'll work perfect. We got some PRs over here. Congratulations, friends. Oh man, I'm so jumpy. I'm glad we're just taking care of this one. This one has just been every login hanging out there. So, sink or swim. We're gonna have it in the books. Also, I do not want jerseys still too much. We're just gonna ditch everything. Best case scenario. Alright, back to 130. 13 seconds. Zone 3 is going okay. I'm digging it. We'll see how zone 4 feels. Remember last time we did the AC workout? The zone 4 part of the warm up just felt terrible. Like, everything seized, it was just bad, so good sign so far. That last one we didn't really plan for, or adjust workouts to, like, coming up to it. So this week we have that on our side. So lower TSS. We'll just find all the positives as we go. Other than lots of zone 5, that's the big negative. Lots and lots of zone 5. All right, one more, then we will say goodbye to zone 3 for the day until the cooldown. Actually, I think the cooldown zone too. So, yeah. Goodbye, Zone 3. We love you, but no longer today. Mletta is very excited about toast, apparently. I agree with that. That sounds good. I think my favorite part about the chats is you'll have people ride past you that are having a conversation, and you only catch half of it. I'm trying to put together what's going on. It's pretty good. All right, got 9 seconds, and we're down to 250. Heart rate is horrendous. That's just so bad. That is no bueno. Just gotta chill. See what happens. Like a little bit of that cough from last week. But we're okay. We got this. It's all gone. It's just residual. All right, 13 seconds. We'll see how it feels. Again, we can work with it if it sucks. But best case scenario, it's not too bad. Ooh, check out that Cat B group. Look at them go. That's a good group too. Shoot, that's nice. Oh, dude, I got sweat in my eyes. All right, let's. The one downside to aero bars is it's super easy to tense up. Well, I guess regular handlebars are easy to tense up too. But aero bars get me every time. It's like when you settle in, it just everything squeezes. All right, so far so good. 3, 2, 1. Okay, I feel like that's okay. I'm down with that. That's not feeling too bad. I like it. A lot better than last time. Now we can just get the heart rate back down. It is spiking like crazy. It'll be interesting to see what we get on the zone 5, as we're already getting peaks on zone 4. Oh well. Ooh, you see that hand bike? That like the level, what was it, level 50 or 60? Like fire line behind them. That looked cool. Alright, back up, 250. Oh, we got 250. 2 minutes. To mentally prepare ourselves, then ride into zone 5. That'll be good. All the pre-workout should be kicking in here. We'll be ready to go. We'll see what happens. Again, float, sink, whatever. We just get it done and we're happy. Either way. Three, two, one. All right, minute here, and then another minute here, and then we're going. Ow, that was loud. I always forget. The music always comes through way louder than the rest of the audio. So I'm switching around. It blasts through. Okay, there's our gate for the halfway point. And then we're going in a minute, but after that we're going. I'm telling you, I'm super jumpy today. It's keeping the heart rate super high. But we can relax when we're done. In 40 minutes. Well, luckily we got 2 minutes in between everything, which is nice. Then we got a 5 minute big one in between the two sets. I don't know, actually. I was thinking of, I wanted to do some tests on the frames, give like a zone 3 workout and see distances and times on each of the different frames and combinations for a little bit. And then, you know, races could be fun. I've only done a couple of them. So, that snuck up on us. But yeah, I'm thinking maybe. I'm still, you know, solidly zone C, or cat C, so it's not super intimidating, which is nice. So we'll see. Also, let's try to pick up the cadence a little bit. All right, there we go. So, we're ramping down. Then we got a 20 seconds where it picks up. All the red is freaking me out, man. Oops. Let me change some stuff. Alright, never mind. I think it's good. Nope, no, it's not. We're gonna do an on the fly fix. Alright, that's the best we're getting. There we go. Maybe, I think low end cat B, maybe. We'll see. I need to do an FTP test, but I don't want to. Those hurt. Ooh. We're getting tight again. Alright, we're 85 RPM. 3, 2, 1. Ooh, 85. That feels weird. There we go. Oh, one down, okay. Body be tight than the lower. So, cheers to that. See if we can get the heart rate down a little bit more. Almost lifted legs a little bit yesterday. I thought it would be a good idea. I'm really glad we did. I'm really glad that was avoided. That would have been no fun. All right, 1 minute. Oh, she's right up there. Oh, come on. The gate. She's sitting up there. Menacingly. But it's inevitable. Oh, dude. I got sweat in just one eye. Alright, we're good. Let's see if we can get the heart rate under 160 before we start. Just nice and chill. Not quite. I think it went up. Okay. All right. 3, 2, 1. Remember last time around the latter end of the 2 minute AC intervals, started getting the taste of pre-workout again. So, fingers crossed, we can avoid that this time. Oh, look at the Christmas trees. That's so nice. Man. Whatever I coughed my family out last week is like 100% gone, and it just comes back 5%. It's annoying. All right, let's get nice and comfy. Last minute 20. Seconds and then 20 seconds. You should have called that. RPM. There we go. All right. Two down. Two to go. And then four more to go. Heart rate not working with us today, but it's getting blood where it needs to be, so I'm okay with that. All good. Eyelashes in my eye, which that's what it's supposed to be, but not in my eye. All right, 30 seconds. Look, cat. my water bottle. Cats are renowned for being speedy, probably. Maybe, I don't know. But we can pretend. Look at all the Christmas trees. All right. There we go. Okay, we're at 0% pack of loss. I'm happy about that. Telling ya, SDN networks, fantastic, till they're not. Like Cisco DNA Center, you have a 9300, you're good. 2960s, won't upload images. It's dumb. Let's pick up the cadence. Just a little bit. Or try to. And relax. Goodness. Seconds. Zone 5 feels like Zone 5. Who would have thought? It's insane. Shoulders again. It's like every couple minutes, back up like this again. Every time. All right, let's see if we can get into 160 for heart rate. Ooh, now he's just hauling. Let him go. And they have the Christmas kit. I love it. That's so cool. All right, 14 seconds. Three, two, one, let's go. Ramp downs. They feel consistent at least. Since it hurts over time, but it gets slower over time. All right, I need slightly faster cadence. Just try to keep 90, 91. About the best we're gonna get. All right, 9 seconds. Three, two, one. 85. There we go. 3, 2, 1. Oh, those are good. Coming down. All right. So we have a 5 minute after this, 2 minute. And then we are back to 2 minutes instead of ramp downs. We're just staying solid. Ooh, nice PR. Way to go. Thanks, Tana. Seconds, we get 5 minutes. 5 minutes. Five of them. 5 minutes. Oh, dude. Back 160s. That is, that's a lot better than before. I'm okay with that. Nice, nice. I was really hoping that we'd have the new setup done this week. But no. That sucker is fighting back. Right now we are getting away with slightly better streaming performance since we're using a network connected dual streaming. I actually had an idea. Trying to put the streaming OBS onto a just beefier VM. And I had it all set up, and for some reason Ubuntu was not taking the NDI plugin. I was so excited. You know, we could just hop in there on the GUI and stream from there. Do all the adjustments. Be kind of cool, you know? Utilize a couple of those Xeon cores. What if VCC memory affects streaming though? I don't really know what kind of errors would come across that to be fixed. But it's ECC, you know? There's a reason that it's there. Load it up with a ton, see what happens. Actually, if anybody's looking for memory, Amazon, there's a couple sellers selling 32 gig DDR4 DIMMs registered ECC for like 60-80 bucks, and it works really well. I've only had one issue with the stick so far, and I've bought a few. But of course, those suckers don't fit in everything, which is sad. In a perfect world, everything would take ECC. All right, 1 minute, 32 seconds, and then we're back at it for 2 minutes. Oh, the blimp's a slave. Ah, it's cute. That's pretty funny. Oh, dude, I'm starting to get hiccups. I hate hiccups. Where's the gate? So these next ones, let's see, we got 1, 2, 3, 4. And we hold steady at 2 minutes for whatever wattage we're putting out. So we'll try to stick that around 90. But if we need to survival shuffle our way through at an 80, we'll do that as well. Last resort though. All right. We got 2 minute rest, symmetrical rest and interval. Let's see it. 3, 2, 1. I said last resort when we started out in the 80s. That sucks. Alright, 1 minute. Alright, two, one. Whew. Three more. See if we can get the heart rate back down to the 170s. That'd be nice. There we go. All right, 50 seconds. Alright, so next one's 360. Hey, that's 25 watts down. That's nice. I didn't realize that. Probably not gonna feel a difference, but it's there. Cool, cool. Thanks, then. Alright, 2-1, let's go. Excuse me. Two songs been writing. We shed the pieces of ourselves. It's perfect timing now. We fuel the flames, but we're still learning to trust, learning to trust. Never enough, never enough. Burning me up, burning me up. Don't fight the fire. So much too fast. We'll burn us out. All right, 30 seconds. Three, two, one. Ho ho! Alright. 20 down for next interval. Cool, cool. Strong enough, our love is strong. Two left. Two more. Alright, 3:40, 2 minutes. I got this. Kinda. Just kidding. We got this. We got this. Get out of the loaded CO2. 3, 2, 1. Let's go. Alright, 50 seconds. Oh. Less watts. Not feeling any better. Three, two, one. Oh, oh. Whew. That's zone five. One more. One left. 20 watts down. Alright, 1 minute. Alright, 40 seconds. We got 3:20, 2 minutes. 2 minute recovery, 5 minute cool down. You're good to go. Source cutoff. Five, four, three, two, one, let's go. Oh, up and around. I was gonna say, what was that? Alright, almost there. Three, two, one. Whew. Yes! There we go. Whew. Now recovery. Last time trial tune-up. Finished. That was good. Shoot! Zero pack of loss. That's what we want. Shoot. I wonder if we get anything. We get any gear? I love me some gear. I think the gravel workouts. You get socks. So let's see. I think. Which other one did we do? I think we finished the beginner one last year and it gave us some stuff. I think. I can't remember. Alright. It's gonna bump us up to 190 and we all walk our way back down from there. Try to pick up the cadence a little more. Ah, I'm telling you, it gets so tight, just like all curled up in there. Usually, try to do a big shoulder day before longer time trial rides, so your shoulders are already tired, and it like naturally, you know, stays loose. It's just not working today. It's just always like this. There we go. We're done. Let's see what we can start doing after this. So, what I really wanted to try was, I want to put together a workout of zone three, so in the 200s for just like an hour, a block. And then each day we'll grab a different frame and ride a set course for the list of frames we have and get it timed. So very interested to see how they compare on like all terrains. Because like a lot of the ones I've found so far, they have, you know, top climbing bikes, top time trial bikes. I would love to do like a climb or a flat out or dirt and just go through the frames and see how much you'll actually lose for each one or how much you'll gain for each one. I think that'd be interesting. You know, put together a cute little spreadsheet. And if we have a workout set for it, it'll keep us in that zone we're looking for and hopefully get us some pretty accurate readings. That way we can work on staying consistent, but then also the workout would allow to, or help allow us to keep it as spot on as possible. I think that'd be kind of fun. Find the different combos of frames and wheels, see how much for each. Because like right now we're using the Dogma F with 454s. Like I want to know if we climb with deeper section wheels, like how much do we lose or how much do we gain? Because I'm wondering if on a lot of them, if you just go hard into one version, you know, like super aero, if it could make up for the times of your climbing. Kind of interesting. So we'll start putting that together, see what happens. I think that would be fun though. Then we can work on some hour endurance sets, see what happens. You know, be fun. I'm very interested to see the differences on the combos and stuff. Because I know on some, like, if you're doing a Ventop, or Vent, however you pronounce it, in the Alps, you know, you want like a very specific climbing bike for best times. But, you know, if that is in a longer ride, are you better off, you know, with a very nice climbing bike? Or if you even it out, would you get a better time overall with like a kind of mountain and aero bike or that kind of thing? So I want to try that. We'll do a couple, see how that is, mix it up. We'll plan on that for the time being. We'll see. Oh, 3, 2, 1. Yeah! That's what we're looking for. Hey, we got socks. We got tune-up socks. Oh. All right. That's a lot of confetti. Look how nice that is. We got all the confetti. It's not stopping. Is that a glitch? Or is it? Okay, there it is. It's done. I was going to say, that was going on for a while. Alright, so let's hop down a couple gears, completely mastigate our average wattage, but oh well, just get a little bit nicer cool down in. Hey. Getting group chats for work. It's like, I'm not there, I don't want to be contacted. There's not a big issue, I don't care. I'll see you when I get there. Alright, let's hop down like one or two more. Ah. There we go. That was a fun ride. I had very worried expectations about that one, so that was pretty much best case scenario. The cadence definitely suffered, but not as bad as I was expecting it to. I remember the last one we were going into the 70s kind of frequently, especially on the ladder ACs. So now this time, I'm okay with that. I count that as a win. All right, let's get to the top of this, and then we'll see. Let's see, heart rate's at like 151, 150-ish. Let's see if we can get to like 140 something. Then we'll call it. Ah. Alright. Nobody look at the watts. It's a joke. We're being ironic. We're not actually in the 90s. That's pitiful. Don't look. Nobody look. It's obscene. Switch on the legs. We are clear. Let's get into a better gear for when we start tomorrow. We don't want to be this low. Alright. And ride. Let's check out our new socks. Alright, how much do we have left of this? Hey, we're done! Cool! Okay, and then this one, I do want to finish the rest of these. So tomorrow, I think there's a, you know, we should probably do, I like sprinting. So we'll do the climbing one just to hopefully, you know, make some progress. I'm not as set up for climbing. So that'll be good to work on. Oh, actually, I kind of like that. All right, that does not match her outfit at all. But I like it. I think it's cool. We'll ride with it for right now. Let's see. Oh, we already checked that. What am I looking for? Oh, I did want to check one thing, though. Let's, where is... Is there a good climbing or time trial? We have the F8. Yeah, we have the F8. They have, this is one I was thinking of. Okay, we do not have that unlocked yet. Ooh, I kind of like this fairing, though. It doesn't have the... Well, does it? Oh, it kind of does. Yeah, that's where the brake is. Oh, check that out. That's not a disc. Those are calipers. Like, not calipers. Disc brakes have calipers, too. The clampy boys, you know? That's the industry term, is clampy boys. All right, what do we have? It was, which one am I thinking of? Oh, that's a nice looking bike. I wish they had the Demo 8. It'd be like the heaviest thing ever, but it'd be so cool. Roubaix. God, what is that? What is that? Ooh, that's a cool color though. I like that. Shiv. Crux, Atheos, that's what I'm thinking of. Okay, there it is. Specialized Diverge Tarmac. more advanced and more. I really like that. That might have to be our next one we get. Because that one's cool. New tech advancements to help keep Avenge. Ooh, look at that cutout. That is beautiful. And there's the Clampy voice again. Infotainment touch screen and improved comfort. Okay, this one has disc. Chevy Silverado, make your missing a pedal. Strong. Look. There's no pedal there. Oh, there's no pedal over here too. I didn't realize that. That's kind of funny.
At Chain Company, we've been experts in the diamond business since.
Okay, so this one, we'll have to buy this one next. Between either a natural, I'm not quite ready to relinquish ring studs that many points. When it comes to so we will diamonds, hold off for the time being. Standards. And yeah, we'll get that. Well, I want to do a couple more of the test rides, and then we'll purchase some gear. Every price range. Ooh, movie star has a the perfect diamond for you. Nice.
Now you have a friend in the jewelry business. Chain Company and ChainCo.com.
No matter how big or small your business is, making your own ad on Spotify Ad Studio is as easy as one.
Ooh, that's kind of brutal. Let us know what you want your ad to say. That's cool though. Awesome. Thank you all for coming. Thanks for hanging out. That was a good. We are done with the time trial sets. So now we we'll plan for the test ride things. I'll try to throw together the workout today. We'll see though. I think zone, you know, 3, somewhere in the 200s would work well to get us enough distance. We can like see the changes a little bit better in the climbing part. I'll do a little bit of research on that, kind of see what's going on. But yeah, we'll plan for that. And yeah, it is almost Christmas, so we'll try to put together some funner streams then. So yeah, thank you all for coming. I will see you later.